Great publicity for this game in the Emirates FA Cup. I'm Martin Tyler, and this is Alan Smith.
Good afternoon, Martin. Looking forward to this. The papers have been full of it this week, and I hope we're not disappointed.
And here we've got for you today, Aston Villa against Tottenham. Combination, Christian Eriksen, goal scorer and goal maker. He just thinks attack.
Oh, he's such a clever player, and I think the message from the opposing manager too, don't concede any free kicks within shooting range, because he's top class from those distances.
The Aston Villa team for this game. Micah Richards starts with James Chester as the centre-back, and today it's just the one striker in the side. This is today's Tottenham Hotspur team. Hugo Lloris starts in goal. Toby Alderweireld starts with Jan Vertonghen as the centre-backs. Christian Eriksen plays with Georges-Kevin Nkoudou on the flanks. And they just go with the one striker up front. Well, I guess it was your ambition as a boyhood Villa fan to play here at Villa Park. When did that first happen, Alan?
Oh, it was in the early 80s for Leicester. Tending to do quite well here. Your family's up in the stand, and it was always a big game for the Brummie, returning to a really old and famous football ground.
Our referee, Jeff Eltringer. Ball on the centre spot. Tingle of excitement that comes with the FA Cup.
It is special, and every player want to get an early touch, settle themselves down.
Moussa Dembele. Nkoudou. There's some potential in this move. And in goes the cross. And it's the goalkeeper's ball, quite clearly a wasted cross. Teammates who are clearly on the same wavelength. Here the challenge is a good one. Nkoudou. Victor Wanyama. Good position. They've worked this attack very well. Into a quite a dangerous position now. Conor Hourihan. Here's Ali. Given away possession. He's coming forward with some danger. And in he goes with the tackle. Good play, but they've lost the ball now. And the opposition could get at them. Moussa Dembele. Christian Eriksen. Feel good about that. A really strong and clean tackle. Nkoudou. There's good progress with this attack. Son! That is very, very unlucky. That would have given them the lead. Giving away the free kick, it's their foul. For Villa, they've got a yellow card here for their player.
Well, it was avoidable, but he jumped in.
These days, running off your feet like that is running the risk of the referee taking serious action.
All right, it's a definite foul, Martin. It's a slight tackle, but he just mistimed it badly.
They've coped with it well defensively. Got it back again from his teammate. Well, we might get an update on that injury now from our man Jeff Shrees. Jeff.
Yes, he went over on his ankle, but we all know what he's like. There's no way that that's going to force him off.
He's got his shot off now. The goalkeeper with a textbook save and keeps the ball in his grasp. Little piece of interplay between the two. On the attack here. A timely challenge. Well, this is how this team can play, sustained attacking football, but when they lose it, as they've done now, it's just a risk that they might get caught out. Stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging. And that's a turnover to the opposition.
Song.
The shot's on! Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free. The front foot now, they've got a corner, hoping for the goal that would put them in the lead. One of the players that we really thought at the start of the game would be the sort of guy we're talking at the end for the right reasons, but we might not mention him in a positive way the way he's played today.
Well, the opposition will just be hoping that these kind of stats continue, because one of the chief danger men has been shackled really well,
and the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one. Decided to add on 2 minutes. Leandro Bacuna. Good interception. Leandro Bacuna. And there is the half-time whistle. 0-0 at the break. He's been in the game, hasn't he? That's the best we can say for him. But not everything he's tried has come off.
He's been a shadow of his normal self out there. So unlike him, and hasn't had a chance, hardly.
He has got the opportunity to change the tactics as well as the players with some movement from the bench. Here we go for the second half of this Emirates FA Cup tie.
Yeah, the first half wasn't bad. Hoping for more of the same here.
Jan Vertonghen. Moussa Dembele. Makes a challenge here. It's big news, this, not just in Italy, all over Europe, all over the world, really. The new Juventus signing. Gardner! Oh, it would be absolutely crucial. It could put them in front of you. Dele Alli. He's coming forward with some danger. Good play, but they've lost the ball now, and the opposition could get at them. Conor Hourihan. A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they've still got the ball. It was nicely worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got to try and regain possession. Nkudu. Attacking now.
To put them in front.
It's good play until they got that challenge in. And here's the shot. He's got it away. Throw for Tottenham. George Kevin Nkudu. And there is some backup for him in this position. Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free. Nicely played through ball. They cope with it well defensively. Quick note for your diary. Make a note of this particular date. EA Sports, we've got the presentation of the Premier League fixture. Spurs, they'll be facing Manchester. And here comes the counter-attack.
Got his shot off now.
Hugo Lloris stops it comfortably. Here we've got the possession stats so far for you, coming up on the screen.
Well, nothing to split the two sides. This is when you...
That's another foul, he has been booked.
Substitution for Aston Villa. Coming off the pitch.
There's some movement in the dugout. We're going to get a change here.
To be replaced by number 27, Richie Delatt.
Good forward play from them.
He can put them in front. A goal at last. First goal of the game. And we've waited well over an hour to get it. But it's the team that have looked the most likely that have done it. And maybe they will use this as a platform to go on to win now. But they will expect the opposition to come back at them. They'll have to. Stalemate is broken here. We have a goal. Well, it might be a good idea just to get a fresh player on and cement their position as they look to hold on to this lead. Time ticking on. Just over 15 minutes to go. Conor Hourihan. Aston Villa readying a substitute here. And they've got a free kick here. Activity on the bench for the losing team. A substitute getting ready to come on. Well, there's a big support here for them, and those supporters want to see just a little bit more in the time that remains.
Well, there's always pressure on you when you're playing in front of a big crowd, your own fans, and the players have shown a few nerves out there today. They've got to lose those.
Dele Alli. 7 minutes to go. Well, heel. That's a foul by Eriksen. Still one down. And they're chasing the game with 5 minutes to go. Richie Delatt. Attacking well here. And the defender tidies that up.
It was nicely worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got to try and regain possession.
Well played. The number's gone up as far as added time is concerned. It's 4.
Yeah, a little murmur goes around the crowd because enough time for me to get an equaliser, maybe even a winner here.
Here's Ali. Final whistle goes. Victory for Tottenham Hotspur. A confirmation then of their success in this cup tie today.
Well, they sailed close to the wind once or twice, some good saves from the keeper, but I think they just about deserve this win.
Well, he's had a very good game, hasn't he?
Yeah, maybe the difference between the two sides. Really solid, really good performance from him.